In 1869, Schliemann divorced and asked a friend to find him a new wife. She had to be Greek and be able to read the Iliad in the original language. On the basis of photographs only, Schliemann chose the 17-year-old Sophia Engastronomenou. His muse gave him two children, Andromache and Agamemnon. With a volume of Homer under his arm, Schliemann followed in the footsteps of his heroes. Trusting in the information of the Iliad, whose accuracy I believed in like the gospel. In August 1868, Schliemann missed his steamer to Istanbul and received the decisive clue from Frank Calvert. The Briton had dug unsuccessfully at Hisarlik, on a hill in northwestern Turkey, between two rivers, close to the sea, surrounded by a vast plain. And this was exactly how Homer had described it. Schliemann noted, "I am now determined to excavate the entire artificial mound of Hisarlik." Excavation work from an archaeological point of view was unknown until then. In 1870, Schliemann cut a 40-meter-wide and 15-meter-deep path through the middle of the mound. Methodologically, a disaster. Schliemann had entire layers of finds disposed of because they did not correspond to his ideal. Schliemann discovered pound-heavy golden cups, large silver jugs, golden diadems, bracelets, necklaces, painstakingly stitched together from thousands of gold flakes. Schliemann believed he was holding the treasure of Priam, the last king of Troy, in his hands. Sophia sewed the find into vegetable baskets, and Schliemann smuggled it to Berlin. Today, the treasure of Priam is in Moscow, in Russia. And a little bit of irony of history. Schliemann had dug in the right place, but over 1,000 years too deep, as it were. He discovered a much older culture between 10 different settlement layers. In the royal tombs of Mycenae, Schliemann discovered golden death masks. He attributed the largest one to Agamemnon. And here, too, he missed his target by about 400 years. In 1874, Brockhaus published Schliemann's Atlas of Trojan Antiquities, for the first time with photographic documents. Schliemann died in Naples on Boxing Day, 1890. His body was buried in a mausoleum in Athens. His bust faces the Acropolis. Heinrich Schliemann was a pioneer of field archaeology and turned the myth of Troy into reality. Well, so much for Heinrich Schliemann, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.